Hello, this is Julie Harland. Please visit my website, yourmathgal.com, where all my videos are organized by topic. Okay, we're going to continue doing a couple more problems where we're simplifying basic complex fractions. And remember, a complex fraction means you have a fraction in the numerator and or in the denominator. So if you do have just a simple fraction in the numerator or the denominator, this part in blue shows the steps, because this means A over B divided by C over D. So I'm writing that with a division sign. And then dividing by C over D means times the reciprocal D over C to get our answer. So we're going to work on this problem here. 12 over 3x plus 1 all over 14 over 3x plus 1. And so this is a complex fraction because it has a fraction in either numerator or the denominator. In this case, there's a fraction in both. And there's single fractions in both. So this method up on top is the easiest way to do that kind of a problem. So we're going to write that as 12 over 3x plus 1 divided by 14 over 3x plus 1. And now we could rewrite that as 12 over 3x plus 1 times the reciprocal of 14 over 3x plus 1. Remember, it's the number after the division sign that you do the reciprocal. So we just switch the numerator and denominator, so we have times 3x plus 1 over 14. Now remember, 3x plus 1 is one big old factor. 3 is not a factor, x is not a factor. This is a binomial, 3x plus 1. And so they're exactly the same in the numerator and denominator, so I can cancel those. I also have 12 and 14. 2 goes into both those numbers. So if I divide 12 by 2, I get 6. And 14, if I divide 2, I get 7. And I didn't write this down. When I cancel the 3x plus 1 and 3x plus 1, there's really 1 left, right? So we have 6 times 1 in the numerator, which is 6, and 1 times 7 in the denominator. So this simplifies to 6 sevenths. All right, so I have a second problem here. 2x minus 5 over 2x divided by 2x plus 5 over 2x. So try that one on your own. Put the video on pause and try it. And then come back. All right. So hopefully you tried it on your own. So again, since I have just a single fraction in the numerator and a single fraction in the denominator, I'm going to write that as 2x minus 5 over 2x divided by 2x plus 5 over 2x. And then, since it's dividing, I could multiply by the reciprocal. So 2x minus 5 over 2x times 2x over 2x plus 5. Now, again, here you have to be very careful. 2x minus 5 is an entire factor. You can't cancel out part of that. All right, but I do happen to have a 2 and a x as factors in both the numerator and denominator. I can cancel both of those. The 2 and the 2 cancel, right, to get 1. And x and the x cancel, those are all 1. But remember, this is like multiplying 1 times 1. And I can't cancel anything. The 2x minus 5, there's no 2x minus 5 in the denominator. So nothing else cancels. So I'm left with a numerator of 2x minus 5 and a denominator of 2x plus 5. Now, it gets more complicated if you have something like this. If you have something like part of a fraction, like 1 over 5 plus x over 2 over, let's say, 3 minus 1 over x, that's a little bit more complicated. It's not in this form that I have up here, just a fraction divided by another fraction. So in other videos, we're going to go over how to do problems that have more than one term in the numerator or denominator.